Today's video, we'll review the second part of building a naive query string parser using type-level programming in TypeScript. Remember to put your thumbs up and subscribe to keep up with this series and future content. In the previous video, we create a simple query structure using conditional types, pattern matching, and type inference, scratching the surface of what combining these features can do for your types and code. If you still need to watch the previous video, the link is in the description below. After extracting the query string part from an URL string, the next step will be to transform the little string into an object type like this one. To fulfill that, first we need to be able to extract the key value pairs from it. We already know, based on what we did in the previous video, that extracting information from some data in the type level programming means using pattern matching along with the infer keyword inside some conditional type. Let's write that type here. The name of this type will be extract key value, and since we want this to be reusable, it will accept a generic parameter named s. The condition will check if the s parameter is a string that matches this pattern of string ampersand string, and let's return true or false to complete the type. We know that we want to extract information from this pattern, so let's change this string here to use the infer keyword and use the name of match and return the match part if the condition is true. Let's test it out by writing a new type that uses the utility you just created. Pass the query string type from here as parameter. Remember that you can think of generics as functions, but in the type level. Always keep in mind, TypeScript type level is pure functional language, so these functions can have side effects. By testing it, you know that it works. It extracts the first key value pair, but how can you get the rest? Here is where the syntax becomes tricky. But the way to do it is a known concept, recursion. Since TypeScript type level doesn't include loops, you need to use recursion to loop over the data. In this case, to extract the key value pairs from the rest variable here, let's apply the recursive utility type and check the result in our test type. Now, you got a union type of the key value pairs, but there is a false. Why? Since you're using recursion to loop over the data, you need to add some rules to stop the recursion. That rule here returns false. Check this. Let's review each part of the recursive loop. In the first pass, the s type will hold the literal value of the entire query string. So the match variable will have the first match found, that is query equal 123. And rest variable will have the rest of the string literal. Now, the second pass of the utility type is the recursive loop, where s will have the value of the previous rest, that is user equal to ampersand test equals some string, and match will become the first key value pair of that subset of the query string, that is user equal to. And now rest will be test equals some string. There is a third pass, so now s is equal to the previous rest, that is test equals some string. And remember, the conditional type here checks if s matches the pattern. And since the new s literal value doesn't match, the condition returns false. To fix this, let's return the original s. Now, the stop rule is when the generic s doesn't match with the pattern, it will return the original generic. Let's check the test here. And voila, all the key value pairs are now extracted as a union type that you can transform to achieve the goal of creating an object type from the query string. In this second video, you review another powerful feature of TypeScript, recursive types. This is the way of looping over the data. The following video will check how to transform that union type into an object type. And at last, get the naive implementation of this query string parser at the type level. Let me know in the comments if you use some of these features in your day-to-day basis. And since you're there, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to not miss the next video. See you later.